What I have here is a screenshot from Google Maps. Now, for any of you who own an Android device, you probably have location services turned on your Android device. Now, this means that you are voluntarily sharing with Google your location, where you go, where you eat, what you do. So let's take a look at my timeline. And for anyone who has an Android device, you can go to Google Maps and click on your timeline to see what Google knows about where you've been. Let's take a look at what Google knows. And I take you back to my Tuesday, April 10 morning. Let's take a look. So Tuesday, April 10, I was in Manila. Google knows that I walked 1.9 kilometers on this day. They know that it took me 23 minutes to cover that 1.9 kilometers. Okay, nothing too exciting so far. Now, where did I go? Well, I woke up, and so Google knows that Isaac Reyes, 33 years old, male from Makati, woke up and walked 600 meters. It took me 8 minutes to walk 600 meters. So they know how fast I walk. I walked to the Anytime Fitness in the Eaton Tower in Makati. I was there from 11:39 a.m. to 1:19 p.m. Okay, I've just pulled all this data from what Google knows about me. They freely share it with people so that you know exactly what data they're collecting. Google's a lot better than other companies in some senses because they share back with you the data that they are collecting. Most companies don't do that. How long was my workout? I was there from 11:39 a.m. to 1:19 p.m. So it was about a 40-minute workout. It looks like I slacked off a little bit. I normally spend at least an hour in the gym. Now, here's where it gets a little bit creepy. So there are two photos or screenshots attached to this location. So every time you take a photo on your Android device, and more than 50% of you in the room will have Android devices, if you have location services turned on, which more than 98% of those users will have, if you have location services turned on, Google will append whatever photos you take at that location to the location, okay? And so I took two screenshots when I was in the gym. Here's the gym at Eaton Tower. I took two screenshots on my phone. Here's one of them. For some reason, I took this screenshot. Did you eat the pandesal this morning? I did not respond. And then I said, is there any more pancit or is it finished now? I don't want to take someone else's pancit, but if there is a leftover, I will eat it. Now, why Google needs to collect this, I don't know, but that's just what happens on an Android device with location services enabled. Google now has that image. So I'm clearly covering all the big issues on this morning. Very important high stakes conversation about pancit there. All right, so let's move on. So where did I go after this? After I went to the gym, I then went to the 88 Corporate Center. This is where our office is in Makati. I went to the 88 Corporate Center. It took me 3 minutes to get there from the gym. It was 250 meters away from the gym. I was there from 2:02 p.m. to 8:17 p.m., so about 6 hours and 15 minutes in the office. Again, we have two photos here that Google has recorded. Okay, it looks like we were doing some sort of whiteboarding session, and I decided to take a photo of the whiteboard so we'd have notes of what we covered in our meeting. We were planning for a training on April 16 on that day. So let's continue. So after the office, I guess I would be hungry by that stage. And so then I went to the Old Spaghetti House, and I was there from 8:48 p.m., 9:14 p.m. I ate very quickly. I actually remember this meal. I had seafood marinara. And it looks like I took a selfie while I was there, very questionable selfie there. I won't be using that as my new profile pic, that's for sure. Okay, so that is just one day. And Google has recorded that information, just like every other day that they have recorded ever since I had an Android device with location services turned on. Okay, I encourage you, go to your Google account, for those of you who are Google users, and I almost guarantee you that you will have location services turned on just like this. Google is following you through your entire life, just like many other companies are. Here we see Google has recorded every single country that I've visited since I've had an Android device, over 5,554 places have been recorded here over 10 years. Now, that is just the location services, okay? That's just where I've been at what time. What else does Google know? They have every single search term that I have ever searched for. Even if I was in an incognito private browser, it doesn't matter. They have recorded it. They have every single video that I have ever watched. This data is being stored. Of course, every single place I've ever, you know, we saw that I looked at, they knew where I'd been, but they've also got every single search on Google Maps that I've ever done. Every single news article that I've looked at from a Google search, they know everything about my business. Okay, we just have 15 people in our company, but we are on the Google Apps for Business software. So they know how many people are in our company and every email sent in our company. Every time I've translated something on Google Translate, they know what I was trying to translate. Every single document I've stored on the Google Cloud, every single email I've basically ever sent, because I've always been a Gmail user. Every single private email, and every single email, company email in my latest company, because we are on the Google Cloud for our corporate account. Every calendar event, every time I was stood up for a date, they know, it's all in the calendar. Google Drive, every file that I've stored, every single ad that I've ran, every photo that I've stored on the Google Cloud. I don't sync everything with the Google Cloud, but a lot of it I do. Every presentation and every spreadsheet. Okay, Google has all of this information, and that's just one company. Aside from Google, Facebook has even more information that Google has. They are a lot more private with it, but they have your Facebook calls, your tags, your locations as well. Chances are you have location services turned on. These apps can record your voice as well, even while you're not in a Facebook call, just using the app. They have the ability to do that. Aside from Facebook, we have all the other apps, and companies in the Philippines are now trying to catch up and collect their own sources of data. And these sources of data are going to be used to target customers. And the noble side of things is that they are trying to offer better products and services to all of you by using your data to tailor those products and services, to design them better, and target you with the right offer at the right time at the right price. Okay, so what's going on here? The image is a little bit faded, but what this is, that's a bus on EDSA, flying down EDSA, and we see an exhaust being left as a trail here behind the bus. While we go about our daily lives, we are also leaving a trail behind us, but it's not an exhaust trail. We leave a trail of ones and zeros. Okay, we leave a data trail behind us, and companies are collecting as much of it as they can.